Good morning, friends. Right now we are standing at the entrance of Musa Jungle Resort, which is the closest to the Manas National Park, which is UNESCO Heritage Forest as well, and such a beautiful, untouched, untapped, virgin destination I ever visited in my 20 years of travel and tourism industry. I'm here at the foothills of Bhutan and Arunachal Pradesh, a place called Bodoland. So Bodoland is the biggest minority community in Assam, with about four districts, and capital as Kokrajhar is the capital, and they live on the northern bank of the river Brahmaputra. And Bodos have struggled a lot for their identity, for their survival, and a lot of youth, since there is no much survival opportunities, so they all were some time back poachers, because you have got such a thick jungle here, the forest. So the government has taken very good steps, especially the Bodo Students Union founder Upendra Brahma, if I'm not wrong. After formation of the Bodo Students Union and also the government initiatives, the Bodos have got a separate identity today, and that's how the Bodoland is opened. And we are fortunate to be the first group of FAM tour being invited by the Bodoland Territorial Tourism Council. So we have been here for past 4 days now, and this is definitely a different feel altogether. Cannot expect the luxury, because when you say Northeast, it has got its own charm in terms of the culture, traditions, arts, tribes, cuisine. Amazing. It's really amazing. It's really amazing. You will really enjoy. I'm actually, you can see behind me the Manas National Park, which is the grassland here. The grassland is about 20 to 30%, but you have got more thick bushes inside, and you can often spot the single horn rhinos here. Then you have the Asian elephants. They're very wild, and the golden jaguars are another attraction. They're very shy. Normally, whichever forest I've been visiting, the first thing you spot is monkeys. They come close to you, but these monkeys are very shy. Sometimes to capture a picture also, you have to really struggle hard, and they have wild boars. Yes, the mother nature is really wonderful, and you will get complete regeneration once you are here. I was also told, when this corona was there everywhere, this is the place where they hardly found any corona symptoms, because of their the medicinal valued plants all around, and such a beautiful forest, and people are hygiene by nature here, and they're all getting educated. The local youth badly need support, and tourism is the only weapon, or tourism is the only industry which can provide the large segment of people getting engaged with various ways of looking after and finding self-employment. You can see the Bodo people behind me walking, and they are very humble, very hard-working people. And I'm so happy to know yesterday during the presentation that a lot of poachers have come and surrendered with various NGOs initiatives, and they have been given back a job because everybody has got their own self-made guns for poaching of animals for their survival. So once they realized the importance of coexisting with the animals, they started surrendering, which is a very good sign. And the beauty is the BTR council and the NGOs started giving them employment back to conserve the forest before the forest department actually came here or strengthened their employability. So the local poachers are converted as employees to safeguard and protect this beautiful Manas National Park. And thus the untouched land started getting its exposure. I strongly condemn that when you say you need tourism, they need tourism. It doesn't mean that you pour with travelers and make it as a mass tourism, and over tourism should be avoided, because this is like ecological balances to be kept in mind. A traveler must be a responsible traveler. Thank God, thanks to the pandemic situation, it taught many lessons to the travelers, how to behave themselves, how to be hygiene, and how to be a responsible traveler at the end of the day. And this is a huge potential for Bodo land. Bodo land is the upcoming destination from India. And greetings to you all once again from Bodo land, and my sincere thanks to TOAT, Telangana Tour Operators Associations, then SCALL International, Thai, who all involved in making this FAM tour successful. And particularly my sincere gratitude and thanks to Siraj Ansari, a selfless man who is always working hard in educating travel fraternity, utilizing optimum utilization of the resources, and he always stands behind. He never comes into the front. Even today he's missing in the tour, but making sure we are comfortable. And the Bodoland Territorial Tourism Council Deputy Director Maitroi Das, the Tourist Officer Bhuma Rani, and all other stakeholders of Bodoland Territorial Tourism, the Assam Tour Operators Association, and all the friends of Assam and Bodoland. Definitely we do our best to do the proper advocacy about the destination, and we will ensure you get a good number of the responsible, mature travelers, not only giving you all the opportunity to develop further, but also to protect the local species, mammals. And another beauty is you really cannot play around with the animals, you know, tie them one area for an entertainment or photograph sake. One good thing I noticed here are we are at their territorial, not animals are coming into our region, we are with them, so we should know how to live with them. And it's really wonderful. And after almost 2 years of suffering from the travel trade, really got a golden opportunity to get regenerated by visiting this virgin forest. And this is just a beginning. I'm sure Boros are looking forward for our support. And please join me to support this beautiful, bold and beautiful Bodo land, and discover a land untouched. Seeing you all, signing off, yours Valmiki from Valmiki Travel and Tourism Solutions. Special greetings from Tourism and MICE Committee, Federation of Telangana Chamber of Commerce and Industries. See you all. Have a wonderful, healthy day. Bye-bye.